Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is all about the fall table decor. Heidi from Happily Thriving Heidi has gathered a group of friends and challenged us to come up with a fall themed table. Here's how my table currently looks for fall. Just a simple fall arrangement. Just added in a few pumpkins and my orange table runner that looks like a sweater. And the rest of my dining room is set for fall. So I don't usually decorate too much for Halloween since my children are older. I used to do a lot more when they were younger, but now I don't do as much. So I wanted to challenge myself and step out of my comfort zone and do a Halloween themed table. And that's what I'm going to show you today. But I'm not much into the gory type of Halloween. I prefer a more spooky touch with a little whimsy and maybe a touch of sparkle. So be sure to check out the amazing playlist for ideas and inspirations. And thank you to Heidi for hosting this fun collab. So here's my table currently. Now I'm gonna get decorating it for Halloween. So here are the items that I picked up for my table, and yes, I probably went a little overboard, but the dollar stores have such really cute stuff that I just couldn't pass it up, and I really don't have anything for Halloween, so it was like starting from scratch. But I think in total I might have spent $40, and I don't think that's too bad considering what I got. First off were these scary crows. I picked up two of them. Some vampire teeth, and wait till you see the idea I have for them. I hope it works, but I thought they'd be cute. Some sparkly spiders, because, you know, you gotta have sparkly spiders. Some battery-operated lights, and they're in purple. Some white and some green spider webs. Some floral picks. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with those yet, but we'll see. And of course this garland, I thought this was gorgeous. The sparkly black leaves with the green berries on it. Not sure what I'm gonna use that for, but I've got that. A witch's cauldron, and I was so excited to find that because that is going to be my centerpiece. Some sparkly black pumpkins. I thought these would be really cute somewhere. Some of these scary black trees. I picked up actually four of them. The other ones are in the bag over there. Some more black cloth, gauze cloth, just in black. Not sure what I'm gonna do with that. I was really excited to find these as well. These black spider placemats, spider web placemats. I thought these were so neat. So I'm gonna use those. And a black spider web table runner. I think that's going to look really neat down the center of my table. So now I'm going to get decorating. So here's how it's looking so far, and I think it's looking so pretty, so good. I'm so excited how it's coming together. I first added on my just a plain white tablecloth, and then my black spider web runner in the middle, and the spider web placemats all around. I love how I scrunched up the table runner. At first I had it lying flat, but you couldn't really see the spiderweb placemat, so I scrunched it up, and I love how it's turning out. And here is my witch's cauldron in the middle. I am loving this. I think it's coming together so cute. Okay guys, look how it's looking. I am so excited. I took those silver skulls off of that stem and I stuck them in the tree. I think that looks so good. Look at my witch's cauldron. I put the green web to look like it's coming out, boiling over, and some of the sparkly spiders in it. And then I just lit it from underneath with the purple lights. There's another tree with more skulls in it. And then the other spiders I just hung from my light. I love it. I just used fishing wire to hang them.
I am so happy with the way this is coming out. It's looking so good. So here's what I did with those vampire teeth. I used them as the place card holder, and I made little coffin place cards out of just some Bristol board. So I put the teeth there, and then I just slide this on. And you can add their names if you want or not, in case they freak out, but that's how I did the place. That's what I use the vampire teeth for. So here is how my centerpiece that used to be in the middle of my dining room table is looking, and I have to say I'm kind of obsessed with it. I took out the middle piece and I added in this pick, and I don't know if you can see it, but it's got eyes on it. I'll have to fix that so you can see it. It's got sparkly purple spider. And then I took pieces of the garland and I just wove it into this here with the green berries, and then a couple of my black sparkly pumpkins in there. And I think this looks so good. And I just put a couple of sparkly black pumpkins down here, and that's how that's coming together. I'm loving this.
So I decided to use some of my black mesh ribbon that I have had for years, and I tied it with some twine around a vase I had, and I am obsessed with the way this looks. It looks so cute. And then I just stuck the branch with the pink sparkly scary pumpkins in it, and the branch that I took off the skull faces from, and it just came to life, and I am obsessed with the way this turned out. I love it. Okay guys, I'm all done and I am so excited to show you the finished product. I love it. I hope you do too. It was so fun and I am so excited to show you the whole thing finished. I not only did the table but the whole room, so I'm going to take you on a little tour of my whole dining room set for Halloween. Thank you. for watching and joining me today. If you are new here, I welcome you to my channel, and it would be awesome if you would subscribe. Remember to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and be sure to check out the playlist of all the other fabulous ladies for more inspiration for your fall decor table. And thanks to Heidi for hosting. See you in my next one. Have a fabulous week. Bye! I've been waiting for this, yeah. It's been up on my mind. Oh, it's hard to resist.